You know what happens when you assume? I remember learning this little jewel of wisdom in a junior high school shop class. Our shop teacher wrote the word assume on the chalkboard. A-S-S-U-M-E. And yes, we had chalkboards back then. Drawing a line under the first three letters of the word assume, he told us that when you assume, you make an ass out of you and me. Just like in shop class, in statistics, you should never assume that the tests you are using are appropriate until you check your assumptions. So why do assumptions matter? Let's say that you call me on my cell phone and I don't answer. You conclude that whenever you call, I must be picking up my phone, I see that it's you calling, and I press that little FU button at the top of the phone that sends your call to voicemail. Perhaps you conclude that I'm mad at you, and I'm ignoring your calls. But what is your assumption? You are assuming that I had my phone with me. And for me, personally, that is never a safe assumption. So next time we meet and you ask me why I was ignoring your phone calls, I explain that I left my phone on the charger at home again. And with me, that's probably pretty likely what happened. But what can we learn about assumptions? If your assumption is wrong, it prevents you from looking at the world accurately. If your assumptions are incorrect, what is going to be true about your conclusions based on those assumptions? Your conclusions are going to be incorrect as well. Now, parametric statistics are built on certain assumptions about the data. And if those assumptions are violated, if the assumptions are incorrect, what is going to be true about your conclusions based on those assumptions? Your conclusions are going to be incorrect as well. You're more likely to be wrong. In fact, Collier et al. Wrote, "All models are limited by the validity of the assumptions on which they ride." So we need to know about the assumptions of the statistical tests that we are using. Parametric statistics require that the population have certain characteristics. Parametric statistics based on the normal distribution assume that the data are at the interval or ratio level, independent scores, no confounds or covariates, the assumption of normality, and the assumption of homogeneity of variance. So let's look at each one of those. First, the assumption of interval or ratio data. This is an absolute necessity for your dependent variable scores. You can't do parametric statistics with nominal DV data. You can do other kinds of tests, but not parametric tests. The assumption of interval or ratio data is easily verified. Look at your data. Have lots of ones and zeros? You have categorical data. Lots of numbers within a range? Now you can do parametric statistics. The assumption of independent scores. Each individual in the sample should be independent of the others. You do not have before and after scores, or people in one group influencing people in another group. Now, if this assumption is violated, you can still use parametric statistics, but you need to switch to a repeated measures design. Or, if you have potential confounds or covariates, you have to control for that in your research methodology as well. Satisfying the assumption of independent scores is done during research construction. You should know what kind of test you are going to use even before you begin your data collection. The assumption of normality. Now, this is a tricky one. A very common misconception is that the data in your sample must be normally distributed in order to use parametric statistics. Or you may hear that the population from which the data are drawn must be normally distributed. Actually, the assumption of normality is that the distribution of the means of the samples drawn from the population are normally distributed. Watch my video on the central limit theorem for a fuller explanation of this assumption of normality. But regardless, you can examine the distribution of your sample scores using graphs, like the QQ plot or the histogram. Or you can use parametric tests for normality, such as the Kolmogorov-Smirnov test. Again, Understanding the central limit theorem will help you see that parametric tests can be used even when the sample data you are testing are not normally distributed, because the distribution of sample means will be normally distributed, even if the parent population is not. The assumption of homogeneity of variance. The variability in each group should be approximately equal. This assumption is really only necessary when you're comparing groups, not with repeated measures. The assumption of homogeneity of variance can be easily tested with Levine's test. With multiple repeated measures tests, however, you should also check for sphericity. More about sphericity in a lecture on repeated measures ANOVA. So now you know what you need to know to check your assumptions. And I have some good news. Parametric statistics are robust. That means that even if your sample data violate the assumption of normality, if they're not normally distributed, you can still use inferential procedures. Again, the lecture on central limit theorem will help explain why. Or you can just trust me on this. However, the more that your data deviate from a normal distribution, the more error enters the test. So you should be particularly careful on interpretations when the result of your statistical test is right on that p equals 0.05 cutoff. But then what do you do if you can't use parametric tests, or if you don't want to, or if your advisor tells you that you can't use parametric tests? Good news, you have options. You can still use nonparametric statistics. Nonparametric statistics are used when the assumptions are too badly violated to use parametric statistics. Nonparametric statistics do not require the stringent assumptions about the population. They can be used with nominal and ordinal data, and this is their real strength. They can also be used with highly skewed distributions. However, parametric statistics are more powerful than nonparametrics, meaning that you are more likely to find an effect that actually exists, i.e., avoid a type 2 error, if you use parametric statistics. Also, these nonparametric statistics cannot be used with complex research designs, and that can be pretty limiting. And that is how you check your assumptions. So with that, you now know what you need to know to make sure that when you're doing statistics, you don't make an ass out of you and me.